हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ एडीए सब्जेक्ट विच इज़ एनालिसिस एंड डिज़ाइन ऑफ एल्गोरिथम्स। बेसिकली इन फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर योर एडीए सब्जेक्ट हैज़ ऑफ 5 क्रेडिट। यू कैन सी द क्रेडिट कैलकुलेशन ऑफ योर सब्जेक्ट इन टू द स्क्रीन बाय GTU। 4 hours of lectures and 2 hours of practicals, total 5 credit of ADA subject is allocated in your 5th semester. For analysis and design of algorithm subject, our prerequisites are programming C or C++ language and data and file structure. These 2 subjects are prerequisite. So in this ADA subject, you will learn about analysis and designing of different algorithms. So basically, what is algorithm? That question we have already studied in your 1st and 3rd semester, means your OOP subject and your data structure subject. So basically, we have studied that algorithm is nothing but step-by-step solution of any problem. Yes, it is true, but in this subject we will know about algorithm into deep. So first of all, let's take a history of algorithm. An algorithm named for the 9th century Pearson mathematician Al-Khwarizmi is simply a set of rules for carrying out some calculation either by hand or more usually on a machine. So what is the perfect definition of algorithm? So algorithm is a set of instructions of how to carry out a process. An algorithm lists the steps that must be followed to complete the process and to reach the solution. Basically, how to solve our problem, that steps are our algorithm. Hence, a cooking recipe can be considered to be an algorithm if it is described precisely how to make a certain dish, giving exact quantities to use and detailed instruction for how long to cook it. We have already studied a non-technical example of making tea into your C language. So our problem is making a tea. Why? Because we don't know how to make a tea. So that is our problem. And our solution is to drink a tea or to have a tea. So for that, we have to solve it. For making a tea, we have to follow certain steps. We have to take different ingredients, we have to mix it, we have to boil it, and we have to pour it into a cup, and then we can have it. So these steps are commonly make a algorithm. Means algorithm is a step-by-step solution of any problem. Here some properties of our algorithm is enlisted. First is finiteness. Yes, an algorithm terminates after a finite number of steps, means it cannot go into a loop. Second, definiteness. Each step in algorithm is unambiguous. This means the action specified by the step cannot be interpreted in a multiple way and can be performed without any confusion. Means if any statement is given of algorithm, so it can be proper definition or proper sentence. Means we can evaluate in only a single manner. Third is input. An algorithm accepts 0 or more inputs. Fourth is output. It produces at least 1 output. Next is effectiveness. Algorithm consists of basic instructions that are realizable. This means that the instructions can be performed by using the given input in a finite amount of time. मीन्स इट शुड कंसिडर मिनिमम टाइम. आवर सिक्स्थ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अल्गोरिज्म इज अल्गोरिज्म शुड बी रिटन इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज. हियर वी हैव रिटन दैट सिंपल इंग्लिश, बट अल्गोरिज्म शुड बी रिटन इन टू अ सिंपल लैंग्वेज सो वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट इजीली. सेवंथ शुड प्रोवाइड द करेक्ट सोल्यूशन. यस दैट इज एसेंशियल थिंग. अल्गोरिदम शुड प्रोवाइड द करेक्ट सोल्यूशंस ओनली. एंड लास्ट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अल्गोरिदम इज एवरी स्टेटमेंट शुड बी परफेक्ट. डिजाइन ऑफ अल्गोरिदम. सो इन दिस फिगर यू कैन सी द नेचुरल लैंग्वेज सुडो कोड ऑफ फ्लो चार्ट. फर्स्ट इज अंडरस्टैंड अ प्रॉब्लम. सेकंड डिसीजन मेकिंग ऑन सर्टेन स्टेप्स लाइक कैपेबिलिटीज ऑफ कंसेप्चुअल डिवाइसेस. सिलेक्ट एग्जैक्ट और अप्रोक्सीमेट मेथड. डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड अल्गोरिथमिक स्ट्रेटजीज. सो आफ्टर आइडेंटिफाइंग योर प्रॉब्लम यू हैव टू मेक डिसीजन ऑन दिस थिंग्स. After making decision on this thing, you have to specify the algorithm or designing of algorithm. After specifying the algorithm, we have to verify it. After making verification of algorithm, we have to analyze it. And if we found it correct, then we can start coding on that algorithm. So this is a simple designing of algorithm. Now, in this chapter, second topics is mathematics related to algorithm. So, in that, we will say, first thing is set. So, what is set? Set is a collection of objects. That objects are called elements of the set. So, A is an unordered collection of distinct elements. In simple, set can have multiple items. Single items or none of the items. All elements are enclosed within curly braces. If A is an element of A, then we say that A belongs to A. Here this sign we use for say belongs to. A is not element of A, then we say that A is not belongs to A. This sign is for not belongs to. Normally, set is denoted by capital letter. The set can be represented using three methods. First is listing method, second is describing properties, and third recursive method. First, listing method. The elements are listed in a set. Example, a set of element which is less than 5. So we will have certain elements like 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this is a notation of writing a set starting and closing with curly braces in between different items separated by comma. Our second method is describing properties. For example, the properties of element of a set define the set. A set of vowels. So that is the condition that describes. Condition describes the property. A set of vowels. So in vowel, only 5 letters will be there. A, E, I, O, and U. So our set will be capital A is equal to A, E, I, O, and U. And our third method is recursion method. The recursion occurs to define the elements of the set. For example, we have the x is a square of n where n is less than or equal to 100. So we have to write only that element which is a square of any other number and which are the less than or equal to 100. So we will have different elements like 0, 1, 4, 16, 25 means 1 is a square of 1, 4 is the square of 2, 9 is the square of 3, 16 is the square of 4. As like, we will have number of element which is less than or equal to 100 and which are square of n. A set is a finite if it contains finite number of elements. Otherwise, set is infinite. Very simple to learn and very simple to understand. If we have finite number of elements into a set, then that set will be known as a finite set. Otherwise, it will be known as a infinite set. If X is a finite set, this is the notation for writing finite set. The coordinate of X denotes the number of elements into the X. If X is infinite, we may write X is equal to infinite. The empty set denotes this notation is the unique set whole cardinality is zero. Cardinality is we already studied into DBMS subject. Again, we will study further into this topic. Here we have N. N is a set and it have 0, 1, 2, 3 up to the set of natural numbers which will be a infinite set. Next, X belongs to X. Here, consider main thing. Small x belongs to capital X. Means X is a element and this capital X is a set. Means this small x element is a part of this capital X set. Again, we can write X is not belongs to X, means this small x is not a part of this capital X set. For example, N belongs to and N is odd. Here, so here X is subset of Y. This sign is used for subset notation. Okay, each element of X is belongs to Y. Another notation is a proper subset of Y. X is proper subset of Y. Means that X subset of Y and moreover that R is at least one element in Y that does not belongs to X. Means in this first notation, means X subset of Y notation, every element of X and every element of Y will be equal and into a proper subset. Here we have written that X is subset of Y and moreover that there is at least one element in Y that does not belongs to X. Means Y set will have at least one element more than X. So it is a proper subset of Y. And in upper statement, each element of X is will belong to the Y. Next is proportional calculation. A Boolean variable may only take one of this value true or false. We have already studied in our Java subject. Boolean can store only two values, true or false. There we have studied that it can store only two values, 1 and 0. So here like that, if p is a Boolean variable, we write p is true or simply p to means p is equal to true. Let p and q be two Boolean variables. That will have different relations. First is conjunction. If we write this thing, then it will be known as P and Q. This is disjunction, means P or Q. Means we have already studied it in our C language, AND operation. There we have used AND sign. We were using IF condition. And in if condition, we were using two different conditions. And that two different condition will join with this AND sign. Means if our condition is A is less than 10 and b is less than 0. So it must have to true both conditions, greater than 10 and b less than 10. Second is disjunction, that is for our condition. Next is negation. It will be generate not p, means our p's value is true, then it will do it false. If p's value is false, then it will do it true. Next is if p then q, and last either both true or both false. Next is integer, real and intervals. So here our first set of is integer values. It contains minus values, zero value, as well as positive values. Second is set of natural numbers. It will have only zero and positive values. Third set of is positive integer numbers. It will have only positive integer values. It will not have zero value. The set of real numbers R. So R will be real numbers. If we want only positive real number, then R plus will have X belongs to R, means elements which belongs to R, but that element should be greater than zero. Next one is, we sometimes emphasize that zero is not included into R plus by referring exactly positive real numbers. The set of negative, non-negative real numbers is denoted by R is greater than or equal to 0 is equal to X belongs to R, means element which is belongs to R, and that element should be equal to 0 or greater than 0. So it will be a positive real values plus 0. Next thing is interval. An interval is a set of real numbers lying between two bounds. It is like a boundary. Let A and B be two real numbers such that A is less than or equal to B. The open interval, first part of interval is open interval. X belongs to R, means X is a element which belongs to the real number set, and interval will be A less than X less than B, means X will be greater than A and less than B, means X is lies in between A and B. Second is closed intervals, means here we will have less than or equal to sign, means X can be A or greater than A. And second condition is X can be B or less than B, means if we have condition 2 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 5, so X can be 2 also, X can be 5 also, and it can also be 3 or 4. So this is example of closed interval. Next is semi-open interval. Means it can be opened at any one side and closed at the another side. So this is the example of semi-open intervals. Here in first example, it is open from the A side and closed from the B side. How we can say that? Because here we have used less than sign only, and here we have used less than or equal to sign. Second example is closed from the A side and opened from the B side. So here we can see less than or equal to sign at the A side and less than sign at the B. Next is function and relation with example. So here we have two sets, capital X and capital Y. Any subset P of their Cartesian product X into Y is a relation. Means if any element which have a relation with the element of Y, then we can say it is a relation. When X belongs to Y and Y belongs to Y, means small x belongs to X, means small x is a element and capital X is a set. Y belongs to Y. In this, small y is a element and capital Y is a set. Then X is in relation with Y according to P. Denote X, P, Y. Here P is our relation. Consider here P is our relation. If and only if X, Y belongs to P. Means X and Y's value will be belongs to the relation. Consider any relation f between x and y. The relation is called a function. If for x belongs to x, means x is an element and capital X is a set, there exists one and only one x belongs to y. Sorry, y belongs to y, means y is the element and capital Y is a set, such that xy belongs to f, means x and y will make a function. For example, we have two sets here. A, capital A is a set and 1, 2 are the elements. Capital B is a set and 3, 4 are the elements. If we make a Cartesian product of A and B, so A Cartesian product B will be A relation with 3, means 1 and 3. 1 relation with 4, means 1 and 4. 2 relation with 3, means 2 and 3. And 2 relation with 4, means 2 and 4. So this is our Cartesian product between set A and set B. Our P is 1, 4 and 2, 3. Here we can say P, which is 1, 4 and 2, 3, is already a subset of this Cartesian product. Hence, A has relation with B according to P. This relation is called function because for each element of A, there exists only and only one element of B, which is belongs to P. Next thing is injective, surjective and bijective. First is injective. In this figure, we can say injective will be have two set X and Y. X will have certain elements and also Y will have certain elements. But in X and Y, there will be relation between these elements. So here we can see 1 is D, means it is a function. 2 is B, means it is a function. 3 with C and also 4 is C. Here X have all many elements that are in relation with the Y with the all elements. So this is surjective. Second is bijective. Sorry, this is surjective. Here injective. So in this figure we can see X is have three elements and Y is have four elements. All elements of X are in relation with the Y set, but Y has all elements are not in relation with the X. We can say example for C. So this is the example of injective. Surjective will have all elements in relation. Here 3 and 4 are in a common relation with C. in injective all elements of x will in relation with y, and last bijective. So bijective will be both injective and surjective, means x all elements will be relation with y's all elements, and it will not repeat any element. So this is the example of bijective. So in next lecture we will study about the matrices. Thank you, students.